In 1989, U.S. President George Bush signed a proclamation recognizing the seven laws of Noah as the principles of moral and ethical conduct that have formed the basis of all civilizations. In 1991, a joint resolution of Congress, U.S. Public Law 10214, stated that the seven Noahide laws have been the bedrock of society from the dawn of civilization. The following presentation outlines the seven Noahide laws and describes their connection to world unity.
There comes a time as we watch our lives unfold, when the world feels strange, future unknown.
Hello, I'm Jeff Weiser, reporting for CBC World News. Last week's unprecedented unilateral world peace agreement, which officially ended all armed conflicts around the globe, has now gone into effect. World peace, once only a dream of religious groups, is now reality. As today, the United Nations reported there were no deaths due to armed conflict anywhere in the world.
Hashem chose us as His glorious design. He'll make this world a better place for you and me.
Today, in medical news, we're proud to report the last mystery of cancer has been uncovered by a British scientist, and the disease has been eliminated from mankind.
In economic news today, the economy soars despite the 12-hour work week, which went into effect last week. The once-dreaded dot-com industry's upturn during the past 6 months has been the needed catalyst to bring the world economy to levels never before seen in the history of mankind.
We are your world. We are your children. We are the ones to show you how to love.
This ideal state of being of world peace, everyone can contribute to this one big family. It is our dream to work for it. I think it is possible. I think we need to believe in the possibility of it.
When the world reaches its point of perfection, it'll be that kind of life. There'll be no war, there'll be no hatred, there'll be no hunger, there'll be no poverty, there'll be no tears, there'll be no pain, there'll be no suffering. And everything that's going on now is just bringing the world to that ultimate stage.
How do we get there? We have to refine the world. We have to transform the world. We have to make the world a better place. How do you make the world a better place?
You need to have a system. The oldest and most universal divine system in place is called the Noahide laws. Noahide because they originate from Noah, who was a survivor after a flood that came as a result of a corrupt world. So in a sense, Noah becomes the man, the father of civilization, and sets into motion laws by which civilization should never destroy itself again.
The rainbow is the covenant in which God states that he will not destroy mankind, and it's a covenant between him and the world. And this shows that God is directly involved with his creatures and that he wishes them to exist.
When he gave these laws to Noah, he said, this is for you and for your sons and for the generations to come. So basically what we're living in now is basically disobeying what God wanted. So ultimately, if we do keep those seven commandments we were given, we would actually do what God actually wanted us to in the beginning.
Number one is that there's a God. There's an eye that sees, there's an ear that hears. There's a higher presence in our lives. We're not alone.
This world has a purpose to it. And that purpose is to make this world a dwelling place for God. And each one of us was endowed with a responsibility to bring that about. And every single one of us has a role in that grand divine plan.
The belief in God is the belief that the world has a manager. It has managing principles that are beyond my wishes and my desires. To some extent, there can be nothing more hopeful than that. I believe that the world is a world of chaos and a world of violence. It's a very depressive world.
I was born in China, a culture that doesn't encourage religion. So I wasn't grow up with the concept of God. However, I do believe in some kind of spiritual being that is overseeing our individual life, giving us direction, if only we can listen to it.
What do you think the purpose of life is?
To try to better the lives of the majority of the people.
I don't think there is a purpose.
God has given each of us a corner of this earth to make a home for God.
Purpose of life is to give back.
These programs really cover the core traditional laws and customs of Judaism that have been around for 3,000 years.
The purpose of going to a wedding is not to enjoy yourself. The purpose of going to the wedding is to help the bride and groom enjoy the wedding.
You know, a lot of people are not going to look at books. A lot of people prefer videos. So if we're not going to produce videos, we're going to miss a big part of the population who could be learning about religion and spirituality.
This is an amazing opportunity to share Torah wisdom with the world.
The Bible is the best-selling book. Why shouldn't it be the best-selling video?